And we're underway with game 4 in the grand final of the Mountain Trail Challenge between Vega Squadron and Power Rangers. So far, Vega was able to win off the first two matches. But then the PR fanboy joined me in co-casting and he gave them some good luck. And I've been able to pick up the the first match for them, the third match in the Best of 5 series. In a pretty convincing manner, they were a little bit behind, but after some good rushdowns, they were able to get back there. And the fanboy here is Zach, man. Zach, you think they got some more left in them to win this game, or Vega is just gonna take this sweep 3-1?
Well, I'm just gonna start off by saying, if this is a J4 Rubik, I'm saying Vega, watch out, and Sunlight is sexy on that Queen of Pain, so I'm hoping to see a very dominant mid, and a very dominant mid game from Sunlight. Even though the clockwork is really good against Rubik and Queen of Pain, like Queen of Pain can't blink out, etc., I reckon that Sunlight could play around this and definitely dominate the mid like he did last game.
Indeed. And just with Sunlight, you know, on the Queen of Pain is just a dominating hero out of herself. Like.
Yeah, even though, personally, I really hate Queen of Pain. Queen of Pain is the hero I despise in Dota 2. Ice Frog, if you're watching, please nerf this hero.
Yeah, I think he will soon, because usually the heroes that get picked up by pros a lot are the heroes that are going to get nerfed. And just his lane dominance, as well as she has an ultimate that goes for BKB.
And the pure damage, as you said. Like, Scepter as well, 40 second cooldown, kills a whole creep wave, it's just horrible. Ice Frog, please, my pub games, my MMR has been lost because of this hero.
But yeah, then we have the Winter Wyvern, really an hero we have seen a rise of coming into this tournament. It's just an hero now, you know, people see it being played more, they see the strengths in it, they see what you can do with it, and it's just starting to pick it up more and more with an ultimate that goes to BKB and just having the abilities to save your teammates. It's just really, really strong in that sense. And just the Arctic Burn, which for the long range, slow in the beginning.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more. I think Winter Wyvern... I don't know why Winter Wyvern hasn't been picked up before, like now. Like, Winter Wyvern, in my opinion, has always been a really strong hero.
Yeah, it has been picked up more in SEA before it was starting to get picked up into the Western scene.
Yeah, and it's just a better reverse polarity Winter's Curse. Like, it's ridiculous.
It has its advantage. The problem is with the heroes that attack him do get, plus so much resistance.
70%.
Yeah, so that's kind of troublesome.
Yeah, but it's still like 3.5 seconds and there's damage being applied as well and the cooldown's reduced.
Yeah, definitely has its advantages.
Yeah, and...
And look at this Vega, they get the mech clockwork here as well with the disruptor, so they're just making sure that there's no chance in hell that they're gonna send him back. And PR, they answer back with the Rubik, just, you know, lift the mech clockwork out of the cox, throw him down on the ground, and say, start walking away, or just throw a full frontal ice blast on his face and try to nuke him down instantly with the quap, together with the fade bolt.
And the cold feet as well, you've totally figured out. Think about it, if he's stuck at the cogs, those feet are going to be getting cold quick. Like, AA is really good against Clockwork. And also against Winter Wyvern. Wyvern doesn't really have much move speed, it's only 285 move speed. So AA really capitalizes that on that, and wow.
And we're going to see a BL here right now for Pasha. There's not a lot of lockdown on the moment of PR, and most of the abilities are, you are able to dodge though. The AA blast goes through it. You're able to dodge most of the abilities from Queen of Bane, if actually all. Rubik?
It can deal with PL illusions really well. The AA Ice Blast, the Fade Bolt, as well as the Queen of Pain Scream and Sonic Wave. I think if Pasha gets farmed, that's the only, like, you know, then he'll be a problem.
Yeah, this is like, the Queen of Pain needs to go BKB.
Queen of Pain has to go BKB, like...
Just the Diffuser Blade is just too good here.
Disruptor, Glimpse as well, really good at countering the Blink, and Clockwork has loads of magic damage early game. And, you can't really evade the Winter's Curse because it does go through BKB.
Indeed, so this... Plus Hookshot also goes through BKB, and if somehow the Disruptor is able to get up on Anonyms, then...
Oh,
you're gonna start
God.
Seeing some AoE Doomstroll thrown out throughout the entire map.
Yeah. And it looks pretty as well. People forget that Ice Frog and the workers at Valve make this game look so pretty, and the new beta as well. If no one's seen that yet, I recommend you check that out.
Earth Shaker.
And Earth Shaker.
And Earth Shaker. Okay, they're trying to get a little bit of the offlane Earth Shaker, maybe going this way, or maybe possibly mid lane. I'm not completely sure what they're going to run in.
Crit Shaker, boys.
That would be crazy.
That would be really fun as well. A few Battle Furies, Daedalus.
But they either need to 5 seconds run him on the offlane, where he's not going to get any farm, honestly. For his Winter Wife and Disruptor are perfectly capable of keeping him out of even XP range. With the two of them. And if you try to get in, you get Glimpse back to the lane again, and then you get killed.
Yeah, Earthshaker can block the creeps alright, though. Yeah. That's one positive.
Yeah,
but
okay, they have that. That is actually really good.
I believe that Wyvern and Disruptor will be on top of keeping the farm equilibrium and be out, like keeping the creep wave really far up, denying the creeps, and also stacking and pulling.
Indeed, and
I'm
just wondering how they're gonna lane this at the moment, because Queen of Pain can either be run on the offlane or on the safe lane, but both lanes are, well, at the moment mid lane is of course the easiest because they have nothing to play against. But the Queen of Pain seems to be the most likely to still go middle and Earthshaker on the offlane. Just try to work around it. The fact that the lane is really, really tough.
I'm really confused here. Like, they've got these three supports, right? One of them could be a core, like core Rubick, core AA. There's nothing to sniff at, really. Like, quick Aghanim Scepter on AA, even though core AA is never seen ever. But it's really underrated.
Yeah, just even just a mid lane AA, it can give you that early level 6, and essentially he doesn't have to leave the lane to gank. Just right, less.
Like an Exalt Invoker.
Yeah, essentially, and then you just have the Global Presence. The one problem is you need to walk back to your tower, because they actually see when you first start to throw it out. So let's say, how do you call it, just the line of array before you really throw the blast out. They already see the animation of that, so if the mid laner pays attention, he can just say Ice Blast, and then top lane, bot lane, and he can just already start walking back.
And Queen of Pain, Rubick, and Earthshaker, if the AA did go mid, I don't think it would, but with these three heroes, they could find a lot of pickoffs. Winter Wyvern, Disruptor, Clockwork, they would be really susceptible to this AA Ice Blast.
Yeah, they're quite squishy indeed. And I'm wondering if they're going to go on Shadow Fiend here. Vega.
Kind of theme works really well here. Against Rubick AA and Shaker. I'm reckoning no one's been really good on this Shadow Fiend recently as well.
Yeah, that's so. It's definitely a possibility, and if the Queen of Pain goes middle, this is probably one of the nicer matchups to get.
Yeah, Queen of Pain does dominate the CS early, but as soon as you start racking up the souls and stuff, Shadow Fiend works, and I think you're right. It might be a Magnus, I reckon. Magnus mid, that's my call. I want to see a no one Magnus. Because you give PL that cleave, you have that reverse polarity on the Queen of Pain, keep her still for a bit. I think that works for me.
Yeah, definitely has his positive points, but the problem is that he's going to get a little bit bullied by the Queen of Pain. Though you have a shockwave to get a little bit back, but still you're going to get bullied. They're going to go for the Shadow Fiend.
Yeah, Shadow Fiend's probably the wiser choice.
Yeah. It's just a safe choice. Like, they're still one game up, but I think they want to end it here. They don't want to go into the full best of five.
They pick the cancel answer.
Yeah, then you just give indeed this. By the way, Rikishi, yeah, indeed, I have the Pyrian Flex announcer pack. But yeah, this is just Vega. They want to make sure that it doesn't get into this full best of five, just to the fact that Power Rangers will get this huge boost of momentum and. Due to the fact that they actually got back from a 2-0.
Yep.
Lycan. And they're gonna go back for the Lycan again.
Yep, TCHR played really strong on it.
And now this is actually really, really tough to play against, because the split push is real. Queen of Pain can easily go in one lane. She has the ability to just blink back. Lycan is just really, really fast if he pulls his ultimate form, and you can just send the AA Blast afterwards as well, just to keep the creep lanes pushed out as well. Or just even use it preemptively to scout. There are a lot of options that they can use here.
Yeah, I reckon this is going to be a really fun game to watch.
Like, as well, I'm just going to start really shouting, Ice Blast! Ice Blast!
Do a Toby 1.
A little bit, a little bit.
No one has ever done that. No one has ever done that in the history of Dota.
Well, no, they just did. And there we go. I'm gonna leave VR to you again because I know you love it. We have Mech on the Clockwork. He's just gonna get. He got the Dire side. We should probably talk about this a little bit more. Clockwork on the Dire side is just a lot better than the Radiant. To the fact that you can cock the creeps and just put them into the woods. Nice and easy. And then we have Seema the Slayer on the Winter Wyvern. We have no one playing the Shadow Fiend. Solo playing the Disruptor. And we have, of course, Pasha playing the Phantom Lancer. Oh, you got that? Oh, there we go. Now you also got a little bit of good luck. Have fun back from the Cheshire Cat.
Brings me a tear from my eye. Oh, look at that. Yeah, Pasha, yeah, Void. There's a bit of banter going between the two teams. And before they have this big engagement, I'm going to go into the PR side. We have Cheshire Cat rocking the Earthshaker. We have Sunlight playing the Mistress Queen of Pain with really nice wings. And we have Gorek playing the Position 5 Rubik. And J4 playing the Icy Apparition. And Ditya Ra playing the Lycan.
And we're going to maybe see a little bit of a clash here on the top rune. With all the teams getting ready to go into this, Pasha is walking on the rune. He has his doppelganger if he wants to get out from here. Fissure. Could be casted soon. They just start walking with four. They're just gonna show dominance here. There's no chance to get back in this. Oh, actually, yeah. This is something that I should have maybe said. Good luck, Joshua Pass 40. They had a little bit of a game matchmaking before this one. This start, and I believe Sunlight together with Pasha were together in the match. So in the lobby, there was a little bit of an argument. So they're going a little bit back to it.
Hey, what happened?
I believe
Did Pasha play a crap Void.
I'm not completely sure what he played the match. I just know that Sunlight played a Lash Wreck and he got like owned like 2-7-5 or something like that. So there was a little bit of a banter there beforehand and. We're gonna see the double lanes again here. Dual lanes, I mean. Look at me talking Dutch. Anyway. And it just trying to make sure that both of the mid laners get a good start here. And so far, Sunlight has been the one having a little bit of a better start to have the chilling touch there. Well, oh no, J4. He walked into a trap. He is gonna take his pill here, but is it gonna be before Solo dies? No, Solo, he is low, but he just gets denied. They don't give anything to them, and there's not going to be any kind of blinks out, so this is just a double kill for Vega. No one gets one kill. The other kill went for...
And no one essentially got two kills. He killed his own team.
Yeah. Sadly enough, you don't get a last hit nor a bounty or a gold for that.
Yeah, that's a good point there.
Ruby get right though.
Well, Mag's on half health here. They should have went, in my opinion. Mag's really far up.
Yeah, if you actually go in on him and you get Cox back, then essentially everything, he can just get out. And he will hold on to his Cox until you lift him up.
Oh yeah, that's a good point there.
So and now, also with Pointy Battery Assault, it's not that easy anymore. And Gorek can't fight with it. If he gets close to him, then he might just pop Battery Assault and just kill off Gorek. He needs to lift him up then instantly, get him out.
Yeah, and he's got the early boots as well.
Yeah. Well, Gorwick is just a lot slower, but they both know the creep wave is coming, so they start walking back after each other. Nessie is just a little bit of friendly poking there. But the top lane, well, Gorwick is having Cheshire Cat is having a really tough time. He does have 4 less hits in the first wave, but now he is... has to start moving a little bit more. Maybe look for gank in mid. While Sunlight, he got what seems to be a couple of raises on top of it. Having been forced to pop this off.
Okay, Cheshire Cat's coming in the mid lane. No one is playing really cautiously right now.
I think he actually saw him.
Yeah, he can see that right now.
He sees him. Quite obvious. The entire walk up there. But yeah, Cheshire Cat, he can just do... As I said, he can do really a lot on top.
Oh god, poor Mag. Have a look where he is.
Oh no.
Oh no.
He's gonna get a TP and... He is gonna be updated soon.
Oh god.
Yeah, please don't say that kind of things in the Ultra, by the way.
I did.
Yeah, there you go. You're not supposed to do that, man.
I'm sorry.
Anyhow,
Looks like
yeah,
I'm
this
just a
is.
bit bad now.
Yeah, they're. Mega's gonna be stuck, but they did level up the courier here, and he is gonna get. No, his courier is gonna liberate Pino, but they're not gonna let him go off quite easy, and they're just starting to put some damage in. You know, some easy right clicks there, and indeed, Lizard, you're kicked from the cast. Never come back.
Oh.
And some cogs out, but yeah, they're gonna get solo in here's one, and I try to TP out, but it's just level one. There's not a lot they can do apart from, you know, this. And what? He could just throw him up in the cliff maybe as well there, but there's gonna be the wolves from Dirty Wild there also scouting Mac out. He's just getting slowly winded down, and Tima also comes in now. They're TPing in a lot, and now Gorek is actually one in trouble. And well, Solo is the next one on the cliff, so they're just trading places.
Yeah, that's unfortunate there. Well, Gorek got caught with his trousers down right then. Not much else that could be said.
No, that it was a little bit unexpected for him. I don't think he expected all the TPs in indeed. And but at least Solo has now also been thrown in it. Well, no one was able to get a kill there on the bot lane.
Yeah, he got a few raises.
There's a haze rune there. So. And now he just runs back to middle. Well, Seema got a little bit of XP there. And will now shortly leave as well. Light raising to the face, he gets off poison a little bit on no one, but yeah, I think the trade is already made for no one there.
Ooh, Sunlight living life on the edge there, but he's got the magic wand charges, so I don't think he'll be going, he'll be taking a fall anytime soon.
I don't think so either. And Pasha, he's building up what seems to be a threat first while he goes into Cheshire Cat. He beautifully dodges. Oh no, and now Cheshire Cat, he's gonna get dived underneath the tower. We'll see, my has also arrived here. He gets off an enchant totem, but it's just delaying the inevitable. And there we go, they leave the kill for Pasha here.
And, ooh.
No one.
Sunlight.
He died.
Sunlight committed the Sonic Wave though.
They were able to get a kill there, so more than worth it.
Yeah, I think that's way more than worth it there. Shadow Fiend. Don't want to get him. Well, you don't want him having way too many souls as well, because otherwise it would just shut out the Queen of Pain, and you don't want that. You want your Queen of Pain to just be dominating the CS, running around the map, taking kills everywhere. And Shadow Fiend was making sure that Sunlight wasn't getting much.
Indeed. Now they're gonna go back a little bit here in middle. So far, it's actually quite even in CS-wise. Just a little bit more ahead for the Queen of Pain. He got a couple more denies as well, so no one is hurting a little bit in the level department, but still, he should be able to catch up more than evenly. And there you go, Arctic Burn on Cheshire Cat. He's gonna get the Fissure off, but he still have Vision Glimpse. No, it's not in range. He's able to just walk away from this, go underneath his tower.
They've all smoked up. They can probably go.
It's already too late, they're too far out. They might look from Meg here. Sunlight is walking up towards him, but he can't aggressively blink in because they might get turned around on him then.
Probably yeah, it's a 15-second cooldown on that blink as well.
And well, they're gonna start taking the stacks that are made in the jungle. Tima, he threw out one splinter best and then goes back. He tries to give as much as possible to no one here. Well, Meg, he gets bullied out of the lane. With poison on top of him. For right clicks, while Pasha is just going for the top tier one here right now.
Yeah, they've left Pasha and HRR alone. I think that Vega believe PL and Lycan with equal farm, PL wins. I'm not too sure, what do you think?
One thing is sure, Lycan will lose that fight, but he can run away, like the good thing that he has.
He can run away.
Yeah, that's he's not gonna win from a PL. Then he needs something like two better views or something along those lines. Or being able to find the real PL straight away and maybe burst him down somehow. But otherwise, there's no real way that Lycan can stand up versus a PL.
Yeah, Lycan, DHRR, 30 denies.
Well, here on middle, Sonic Wave is gonna use, but he gets double raised by no one. So essentially, it's actually a really good trade for Faker. They just give up their. Position 5 for an position 2, so I don't think they're mourning the death of J4 too much. J4, what's wrong with me?
Wyvern, I think that's Solo? Solo playing the Wyvern? Oh
Solo,
no, Seema. Seema is playing Wyvern.
Okay, it's actually position 5 then.
Oh, that's unfortunate. Okay, no one dirty plays on Gorek. Oh.
Well, Gorek, man, he gets thrown. Yeah, he threw him back a little bit, but it's not going to be enough. And no one, he keeps on fighting the Haze Runes all over the map.
Oh, there's a hook in on J4 on the bot lane. Dicharaz coming close now.
He's going to get... Oh, no. Yeah, there we go. He'll still get it, but he will die. He will die to this. The big bad wolf.
I think that's worth it for Power Rangers there.
Moi. For Mech, it's also fine. He can just keep on getting kills. And we already have a 9-minute mecha here from no one.
Oh, that's really quick. Well played.
Yeah, this is just going to get a lot tougher now for PR. They're not really having the Isis right now to contest this. Is there... There's another Midas on Lycan again. He got it really fast again. And yeah, he's just looking into a... BL. He got a kill on two Cheshire Cat on top. Echo Slam has been used, but... It wasn't enough to kill off the PL, and he actually went for the Vladimir's here as well.
What could be really good here is J4 with the Ice Blast as well. Like, that stops all healing, so Mechanism and Winter Wyvern could be, like, useless, really, if J4 gets a really good Ice Blast off.
Yeah, but luckily, level 1, you're easily able to just wait out the duration and then pop your Mechanism most of the times.
It's only 6 seconds, I believe.
Yeah, but yeah, I believe 6 seconds.
Eight seconds.
And he gets found now by Mech. No one is there as well. Is he gonna get the raise off? There you go, raise. He picks up the kill. He's a killing stream. And there's gonna be the fissure blocking off Mech, but Dirty Ra, he doesn't have any mana right now. Sunlight goes in aggressively. Requiem is used, slows him down. But there's gonna be the lift up back on no one. He gets off a raise. He just kills off Gorek here. Now Sunlight, he doesn't have a blink just yet, but he's gonna get glimpse back. Maybe does he blink now? No, he doesn't. Still 2 seconds on the cooldown there, and even then there was still the Cox. No one gets a triple kill.
Yeah, so 3-0 trade in favor of Vega.
They might even find the tower. Oh no, Dirtura. He is gonna get lucky in here with the kinetic field. And now, yeah, they're just gonna start walking him down if they're actually able to find him. Okay, there we go. Dirtura, he's gonna get Splinter Best on him, and Spirit Lance from Pasha is more than enough to kill him off.
Oh, the puppies. Puppy wolves.
Nope. No, the wolves aren't enough to kill him up. Solo will walk out there.
Yeah, that's really unfortunate for PR as well. Like, 4-13, well, it's 3-13 because of the deny, and just not looking good. Like, level 3 Ancient Apparition.
Yeah, that's just not what you want. Well, putting out some arrest fissure also is no one. But yeah. If he wants to, he can just pop his Mechanism.
J4 stacked their own... The other per... Here. They stacked the other jungle. Like, the enemy jungle. Yeah, he stacked that camp.
No, that wasn't J4. J4 is on bot.
No, he just TP'd out.
Really?
Oh. Yeah, I was just watching him.
Well, he's just gonna die here because Mech gets off the hookshot on top of him. And his spear and lens there. Is enough to kill him off. Dominating streak for Pasha. I actually didn't see that. That's actually quite odd. But yes,
maybe things was coming out on Gorek.
Maybe he's looking at farming it later on with an Ice Blast or something like that.
Oh yeah, that's a good point. And Solo's wrapping around on Gorek right now.
If Dirty Rust stays here, he might actually get found. Like, it's actually low, so probably not gonna go. He will find a rune now though. Well, Pasha as well as Dirtura see each other. Ooh, no, he's not gonna get the Courier here right now. And here you go, Dirtura, he pops his ultimate form. Pasha, mind that there is not a hookshot just yet, 20 seconds left, so. But both teams will just leave it at some friendly poking again.
Yeah, there's a lot of friendly poking going on here. I'm not sure if this is erotic or not.
Well, this wasn't a friendly poke, that was a nuke in the face of Sunlight. He didn't like that. And Solo, he starts walking in, and Gorek, he might just be sacrificial lamb. No, they don't see him. Solo, he wants to get out of ward here, or a little bit further ahead. Between the two towers, I'm gonna assume, but he's gonna run into Sunlight here. They might just know it. Oh, Sunlight, he actually goes aggressively, they can glimpse him back. There you go, he gets found by no one here, and he meets him with his raise as well. Pasha also gets a kill here. Oh, that Rubik just died here to Mech together with Pasha. And there's two people dead on the side of PR, and it should be in the tower for Vega.
Not looking good in The supports on the Power Rangers side, nowhere near level 6. We have a level 5 Rubik and a level 4 Ancient Apparition. They're just more ahead, really, in terms of levels and farm Vega. I think PR, they've played really well, but I think they're going to lose this game.
The late game, the problem is there that PR won't win versus a PR with a Shadow Fiend. That's just too much, and they have more than enough lockdown in late game to keep them down as well. Like kinetic field with an Aghanim in there before you pop your BKB is so incredibly strong. And even if you pop your BKB, they have a Winter Weapon, they have Winter's Curse. And now they even lose the rush. Essentially, if Vega gets the rush, it's just stealing it from PR because they have the Lycan. If you have the Lycan on your lineup, you just need to get rush. And not getting it is so tough.
I don't think Lycan's so good on the Radiant side, and I feel that PR know that.
And even with two people down, it doesn't matter. Ooh, I actually missed that one. Washa gets even found behind his own tier 2. Okay. Well, they should know that there is a ward out there. And oh, Glimpse back. He's gonna get found by Seema. Seema's slowing down. He doesn't want to ulti him just yet. Now he will. Because no one is now close. Raises. Nope. Link out. He gets to top and he just starts TPing away. You're not gonna be in hookshot in time. Seema could have possibly waited a little bit longer there with the Winter Curse, but
yeah, they could have waited a little bit longer, wait for no one to come in, and
as well solo to maybe get off a static storm, but it's all really, really, it would have been really, really close.
Now, PR need a miracle, quite honest.
They definitely do.
Yeah, they've smoked up now the side of Vega. They're probably going to look around to the two supports of PR right now. J4's hiding in the trees.
TP instantly. They know this, and they're gonna start running away with Warwick. He just walk over an observer ward, maybe an hook shot while his teammates are blocking him a little bit.
Oh. Yeah, Cheshire Cat's dead.
He's starting to TP out right now, but he's just gonna get glimpsed. They're gonna kill him off. There we go. Shadow Fiend picks up a kill. He's already on a wicked 6 streak here. Man.
Yeah.
9-1-0. Barsha, 5-0-1. Oh man, they're really, really racking up the kills here. Yo, green
dudes, something. Yeah, and hopefully they stop because I need to win this. Come on, PR. Ah, they've come back from worse than this many a time. They're 12,000 gold behind at 15 minutes in. Oh dear.
Man, this is a really steep hill to climb. Well, there's gonna be another hookshot on J4. He finally found his level 6. He's gonna throw out the Ice Blast, but it just hit some creeps. Glimpse back on Dirty Bra. The tower is not in deny range. But there's no real rush for Vega to go after it.
So, as part of Power Rangers, what do you hope for? Like, do you
big
hope
mistake
for smoke
Vega
or big mistakes? Like,
essentially, you can't really teamfight, you just got level 6 on your supports. While the enemy supports are not that much ahead, but you're just really, really far ahead. You just need to hope that you get a big combo off at your base. Echo Slam, Sonic Wave into Ice Blast, and there we go. Dirty Raw, he's found out, he's gonna get thrown into the Kinetic Storm Static Field combo. He's gonna get glimpsed back into it a little bit more, but they're gonna retaliate here. They're not even gonna get a kill on him. Sunlight comes in with a nice Sonic Wave there. And there's gonna be a glimpse stolen here. Gorek. They able to find somebody. Fairlands. Solo is low. They're gonna use Mechanism. He's gonna get brought back here. Well, Pasha goes in the backlines after Dirty Rod. Dirty Rod tries to TP out, but it won't work because Mech is there with the hooks helping him out. Solo, he throws back Sunlight. He just showed up in front of no one. Well, at the same time, both supports also died on the side of PR.
Yeah, that's looking at the fight recap, that's a massive goal swing for Vega again. I feel like PR played, well, they drafted to counter pick Vega, and like picking up the Earthshaker, I haven't really seen Cheshire Cat ever play Earthshaker in a competitive game, and maybe it wasn't his hero. Like, I know these players are all very experienced and just very probably play every hero in the game, but Cheshire Cat really got zoned out, and it wasn't his proper forte of a hero. Like, he prefers more aggressive heroes, more survivable heroes, and Earthshaker's just not his guy, to be quite honest here.
Yeah, this is maybe just indeed not his capability, but he has 2.6k net worth, and he still needs what 400 gold for his blink.
Like, he's one of the best Batriders I've ever seen, and I reckon Batrider could have been really good here.
Would have been nice, and they have something to lock them down through BKB. It would be hard for no one to deal with.
The Batriders sort of drifted out of competitive recently. I don't know what's happened.
I think we'll see him again in TI.
I reckon he'll come back, yeah. It's always fun watching a Batrider anyway.
Yeah. It's just nice to always have an offlane that go back into the jungle, in my opinion. You always have something to fall back on. But Cheshire Cat, if in an Urchecker, you just need to have a good offlane, or you need to get a lot of kills in the mid game. Or early to mid game. And he had neither. He had 4 deaths and 0 assists or kills. He will have his blink now at 20 minutes. But it's fairly late, but they will need it definitely for the base defense.
I think they are sort of relying on Cheshire Cat to get the 5-man Echo Slam with all the PL illusions.
Yeah,
like, that is the main thing right now.
Yeah, that's what they need, and then they can just follow it up with an Ice Blast and Cinnabar.
Like, I really do hope that I don't want to say it, but get their act together. Like, they're really sloppy at the moment. Like, their movement around the map and with the ward coverage, there isn't any at all, really. They just need to sort it out and need to get their heads down.
That's going to be tough.
Yeah, it's going to be tough, and HRR is the highest up on the net worth right now, and he's got that Midas for late game, but he's been really punished by the side of Vega. They know that. He's gone for the Midas. He can't fight early. Let's put him down further.
And he has 2.2k gold now, and I think he is debating whether or not to go for a Necro Book or start building up towards the BKB. Those raises are close. He's standing still? One raise? Okay, he's still. Well, oh no, and he blinks aggressively forwards. He even pops his DD for this. He's gonna start TPing out, but that doesn't matter because there is Pasha Spirit Lens with the raise. A lot of magical bursts, enough to kill him up there on his less HP. Yo, green dudes,
something bad is happening. In your body. Yeah. And Roshan's not going to be up for a while, which I think is pretty good for the side of Power Rangers. Like, for the reason that they have no chance of getting to Roshan, and just it not being up gives them a bit more time to farm up as well, because as soon as that Roshan's up, Shadow Fiend's going to walk in there, take an Aegis, go high ground, and smack some tier 3s and 4s.
And the only good thing that they have is that they have a scouting mechanism in the Ice Blast.
Oh, and the little wolves as well.
Yeah. But I'm gonna assume they're gonna put down a sentry before they go in.
Oh, of course, yeah.
That's just a safe play, you know. You don't want to get your Aegis denied by a wolf.
Like,
no, that's not the kind of thing you want.
That's like pub story all over again, isn't it?
Yeah, well, it happens from time to time. If you're just not diligent enough on it, it can actually just happen in a pro game as well. But I don't think they will do that. I'm pretty sure they will put down a sentry.
Yeah, that's probably the best thing to do.
Well, Mental Style is now completed on Pasha, together with his Diffusal Blade. He's looking really, really strong right now. And just to say, even if PR is able to drag this game out, they have the one problem is that they're getting starved all over the map, big ass farm. PR, they just are like a little bit like this is where they can farm. There's just not enough space. And you can just look how it goes. The net worth keeps on going down steadily. Now 20k gold already. And 14k XP. Well, Cheshire Cat is blocking in J4.
Oh, God. I think they're just having a bit of fun now. I don't know yet.
Yeah, he's
there we
away.
Go.
But yeah, that's... they're just really, really far behind. And they do want to make sure they get another match here. Well, no, and he's going really aggressively. He finds Gorex here. He pops his 10 seconds BKB for this. And now, will he pop the Requiem? Yes, he will. Dirty Rise to start running away, as he will. J4 on there also comes in. Well, Mac with the hookshot finds somebody else here. He found Cheshire Cat. He's gonna die now again. 0-5-0. Well, Dirty Rise finding up versus Mac. Mac is low. Sonic Wave on top of him. He's gonna get killed. There's a dominating streak down and going to Lycan. Well, they're all fighting over the place and they find the kill onto Dirty Rise. Well, DP out from Sunlight. Nope. Gleams back straight into the fight, into the Static Storm, but he is able to walk out of it right now. And they keep on going after him. 2 seconds on Blink. And Blink. Oh, he blinks into the courier. I know where he is.
Oh no, keep running, Sunlight, run!
And he has Bleak of cooldown again, so he's able to get out again.
Yeah, he's definitely living life on the edge there, Sunlight, and that was a really bad trade again for Power Rangers. At least they're trying to get some kills back.
But just 1-4-4 is not worth it at all.
Vegas is going to run high ground right now.
There's no real reason for them to stop. They just got this incredible lead. Especially with Gorek dead as well, it's going to be tougher. But they're actually just opting to wait, still wait for Rush. It will be up in about 40 seconds or so, maybe 50. Somewhere between there, so. Oh, and he's just gonna start.
Not here now.
Asians here, Pasha is back to farming this lane, and they're smoking up. This is a bit of an Hail Mary smoke. If the Rush isn't up, and they can't get it now, it's gonna be really tough, but they might just go for the Pasha kill here. They need to blink Echo straight away.
Yep,
Blink Echo, there we go, Fissure is there as well. Pasha is getting blown up, there's gonna be the Ice Blast as well, but they don't even need it. He gets killed up, Sunlight getting the kill. 1200 gold for him.
Big rubber bonding.
Well, there comes Mac. Mac hookshot into Cheshire Cat. He gets a lot of damage here going his way, and he's able to get Cheshire Cat before he dies, but that is actually not worth the trade right now.
2-for-1, that's really good. Like, coming back now. Oh.
Well, there's a, what Vega's walking one by one, they're not really able to. Okay, they're gonna find J4 here. He's gonna die without getting out.
No idea how many that 2 for J4's 2. Infantry?
J4?
J4's infantry.
Yeah. He is going mess. He's just building up stats. He just wants to survive, and well, even with this, yeah. It's gonna be really, really tough. Disruptor.
Yeah, no one.
Man. Just wanna say solo, he has a gem.
Oh.
So look, it was either sentries or a gem, and I guess they went for the sentries and for the gem. And
yeah,
to get the, there we go.
With the gem, they can spot out the Lycan Wolves as well. And Cheshire Cat's been relegated to that hard support right now. He's buying up the wards. Oh, poor Cheshire Cat.
Yeah, he's. This wasn't his game.
Wasn't his game. Last game he played really well, and the games I did see before, he was also on point as well. But not his game this game. But I hope to see more from him in the future.
Oh, Mac. Sunlight is there with an invisibility room, but Sunlight alone, I don't think he can kill Mac here. He does have a 4 staff, and there are, you know, there's a chance of TP rotations in. That's why Dirty Rising are also coming in. But Mac, he knows something is up. He is staying close to the tower. Wolves are taking up the creeps here, so he knows there are people in the neighborhood.
Oh,
and he spot them out, he knows.
Yeah, the flare went straight over his head.
But he's still walking into them. He's walking towards the rune. And there's gonna be the TP in! Oh, the Ice Blast is off the mark though, but Mac will still take a fall here. He 4 steps forward. Oh, what? He might actually survive from this! He hooks it towards the creeps! But no. No. Sunlight said no.
Aghanim Scepter on Mag now. Oh god, and the
base, man. This is just all a diversion.
Yeah.
Well, they were able to kill off J4 here. They're also able to kill off the tier 3 as well as the Rex here. It's gonna be the melee Rex down, and what do those PR guys instead? They get a tier 1 on top. There we go. There's a full lane of Rex down, and now they're gonna go for the tier 3 in middle. They already have the creeps here, and they just start laying in this damage, man. Just look at it drop.
Oh. Yeah, and Ditcher has, okay, the TP's off cooldown now. He's got to regen some mana and base.
And, well, that's not going to be happening because no one, he's going to get blown up. He gets a Glimmer Cape on top of him, so he might just survive through this with the BKB as well. Well, Cheshire Cat is going to take a fall here. Pasha, he just blows them up as well. Now Dirty Ra. Well, he does get off a kill there, but he has to pop his BKB right now to start running away, and they will just leave him alone and start laying in a little bit more damage here. They also buy back on no one. They want to end this straight away. He's still after Aegis or Pasha.
I think it's GG, Sander.
Yeah, man, this is GG. This Vega are most likely going to be the winners of the Mountain Trail Challenge here. Look at this,
really,
this tower is also falling.
The PR played really,
okay,
really
they're gonna
well
try,
in the last
they're gonna
game.
Try it now, they're gonna try it now. No, yeah. It just is Pasha, they can still go in. We have Sonic Wave, but yeah, he just throws it out, he gets a lot of damage and he has to start going back. Well, the Mac hook shot was on a creep. Pasha goes forward again. Oh, Gorak, he's gonna take a spill to the creeps here. Well, Pasha will. Oh, he's actually still alive. He's gonna get saved here by the Cold Embrace. I thought he might pop his Aegis there, but still alive. This is gonna be Vega, Creeps, and PR. They are done with it. They call GG. Are they able to kill Pasha? Nope. GG. GG, yeah. Well played, Vega.
And that's it.
Vega Squadron, the winners of the MTC Mountain Trail Challenge. They won it in four games here. They had to go through a really tough road. They got bumped into the lower brackets by Hey United. They got the revenge on them in the semi loser bracket final. They had to fight the entire way into the bracket, essentially. And showed up here to the final. They came here to play. They just won. They were all serious here. 3-1. They win 3,000 euros. 1,500 euros will go the way of PR. 500 euros will go the way of London Conspiracy. Zach, what do you think of all of this?
Well, I'm sad about Power Rangers losing, but I know that they have the potential to go on to win bigger and better things soon. And thank you very much from me. Follow me, add me on Steam, etc.
Yeah, and I want to thank, of course, all our sponsors who have just been making this possible. We have EBAT, we have HyperX, we have, of course, Intel, and we have Asus ROG, Republic of Gamers. And those were our sponsors. Make sure that you all check them out, buy their products, all of that good stuff. And we'll be having more and more of the tournament, so please follow our channel as well, follow our Twitch as well as go to our Facebook. Our Twitter is Swiss_DC. You can just find us on Facebook, on the Swiss Dota community, Swiss DC. And well, guys, GG again to Vega. This was the Mountain Trail Challenge. I had fun being here, guys. I had fun casting for all of you. I hope you enjoyed it as well. And let's just show some community. That's it.
Bye, everyone. Thank you.